हमारा ये प्रोग्राम एलजीसी और जिसका ताउन किया है इंडियन मुस्लिम वेलफेयर एसोसिएशन के प्रेसिडेंट जनाब अतीक़ुर रहमान साहब और जिन्हें हम मोन भाई के नाम से भी जानते हैं, तो इंडियन मुस्लिम वेलफेयर एसोसिएशन के बारे में उनकी साहबजादी आयशा रहमान आपके सामने अपने तासरात पेश करेंगे।
अस्सलाम वालेकुम, रिस्पेक्टेड सदर मुशायरा, ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट एंड डियर ऑडियंस, आई स्टैंड हियर एज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ इंडियन मुस्लिम वेलफेयर एसोसिएशन एंड वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस इमेंस ग्रैटिट्यूड एट योर ग्रेशियस प्रेजेंस। मैं किसी से बेहतर करूँ क्या फ़र्क पड़ता है? मैं किसी का बेहतर करूँ बहुत फ़र्क पड़ता है। These lines that I just iterated sums up the vision with which Syed SHUAIB-UR-RAHMAN laid the foundation of Indian Muslim Welfare Association in the year 2004. A man of immense caliber and compassion, SHUAIB-UR-RAHMAN Sahab was soon successful in embracing the needy through various schemes regarding IMWA. This evening, I would like to present briefly before you incentives and schemes through which IMWA reached out to the marginalized section of the society. The modus operandi that IMWA employs is simple. That is to provide the basic necessities to the needy to make their lives functional and productive on a daily basis. Hence, IMWA distributes rations during the month of Ramadan. Also, just prior to Eid, a pack consisting simai, sugar and milk containers are made available to the needy. As winter approaches, IMWA indulges in the task of prorating blankets. IMWA has decided upon an apt pension of ₹500 to be issued to all men and women, to the physically challenged every month. Basically, this pension is made available to the twice marginalized of the society, all those who are unable to even earn a bare minimum. A medical support system also runs under the umbrella of IMWA. It entails free of cost medicines for the deprived section of the society. Also, IMWA runs a computer training center that imparts technological skills to those enrolled as trainees at no expense at all. In addition to this, educational fee is also provided to school and college students to promote education among the economically marginalized. Along with the establishment of Indian Muslim Welfare Association, a special arrangement was made for Urdu and Arabic studies that bore fruit 2 years later. It was in the year 2006 when Syed SHUAIB-UR-RAHMAN formally contributed to the upliftment of Urdu language, the cultural mirror to the city of Nawabs, by establishing this very library where we all are seated and hopefully would soon witness a splendid evening. The library received much love and recognition from the city and was soon showered with books from the surrounding literary circles. However, mostly it has been home to a collection amiably arranged by the Bani himself. Also, the library wholeheartedly welcomes all, irrespective of age, gender, religion, to acquire costless education of Urdu and Arabic language. The library not only accommodates vast material, but also accommodates knowledgeable ustad and ustani to cater to those seeking the cosmos of the languages. Also, IMWA presents a cycle to the young boy and a swing machine to the young girl as a token of appreciation, whomsoever completes the recitation of the Holy Quran. IMWA not only works towards the economical upliftment of the downtrodden, but also works towards the spiritual elevation of the masses. It organizes a Jalsa and Natia Mushaira every year. Also, a Hajj Tarbiyati camp is organized to educate the Hajis every year. Unfortunately, on 25th March 2013, SHUAIB-UR-RAHMAN Sahab passed away, leaving behind Indian Muslim Welfare Association and his legacy, Main Kisi Ka Behtar Karun, into the hands of his younger brother, Syed Ateeq-ur-Rahman, and son, Mr. Azhar-Rahman. Syed Ateeq-ur-Rahman had worked as vice president earlier during the lifetime of his elder brother. Tables turned, nameplates reversed, however, the roles remained the same. IMWA is presently functioning under the presidentship of Syed Ateeq-ur-Rahman and vice presidentship of Mr. Azhar-Rahman. The motive still remains the same, to uplift the downtrodden. I would like to specifically mention here that this idara is not aided by government, but functions solely through hum and aap, as well as the zakat accumulated during Ramadan. With this, I would like to conclude my speech. Thank you for patiently lending your ears to me. I hope we have a beautiful poetic evening ahead with fond memories to recapitulate later and the onset of a new history in the name of LGC Lucknow Global Collections. We wish you luck.